it, you got it. Wow, did I get a lot of requests for this one. You people really want me to review Call Me Maybe by Carly Rae Jepsen. I even got a message from my paymasters at blip.tv saying I should review this. Oh god, when even the people who sign my checks every month are telling me to review something, by god, I guess I'd better start. And I guess I should for all of you guys too. I haven't gotten a flood of requests like this since With My Hair. But there was a major difference there. With My Hair I got a ton of requests for because everyone hated it. But Call Me Maybe appears to be a song you all like. Hey, I just met you. I seriously got all these requests saying, I love Call Me Maybe, but I really want you to review it. Oh, okay. I guess that's just a sign of this song's incredible mass appeal. Carly Rae Jepsen's rise has been nothing short of astounding. Here's Jimmy Fallon and The Roots performing it on Late Night. And here's Colin Powell performing it too.
But here's my number, so call me maybe.
Everyone loves this song. Right now, it's even a popular meme on the internet. Before I blinked, this song turned into the guilty pleasure of millions. But not your girl Uncle Todd, right? Surely Mr. Grumpy Pants Pop Hater over here can be counted on to give this song a good thrashing. I mean, why would he even be doing an episode on it unless he hated it, right? Right? Okay, before I say anything, you do know I have done reviews of stuff I like, right? I've done it a few times now. Also, I keep telling you guys I actually like pop music. No one ever seems to believe me. I wouldn't be doing this if I disliked everything. And what about Call Me Maybe? Do I like that too? Well, no. No, I don't. I think it sucks a little. And watching the whole world go nuts over such a completely unremarkable slice of stale cheese as this is kind of pissing me off. I have absolutely no idea why the internet is geeking out over this lame little cuckooing, tee-heeing piece of oversugared preciousness. And this song's just not very good, and I hate to tell you this, but that meme, it's not funny. It's never been anywhere even remotely funny. Not even the Arrested Development one. Now, TikTok, there was a meme-worthy song. She brushed her teeth with a bottle of Jack, remember that?
Brush my teeth with a bottle of Jack.
That's something you build jokes off of. And the track popped and buzzed with excitement instead of these soft-ass fake strings. It was memorable, damn it. Call Me Maybe just isn't. Why is everyone, even serious music critics, going crazy over some twee little tune that rhymes maybe with baby? I expect so much better from you, internet. Yeah, call it a guilty unpleasure for me, I guess, because a big part of my reaction is mostly just overexposure backlash. I realize that. On its own, Call Me Maybe is nowhere near the worst thing I've ever heard. But at the same time, let's be clear here, I took a dislike to this song pretty immediately, from the very first moment I heard it. Okay, let's see how we got to this point. Carly Rae Jepsen, of course, launched into popular consciousness after being featured on the super influential, star-making powerhouse of television, American Idol. Sorry, Canadian Idol. You know, funny thing about American Idol, despite its massive success, it doesn't have a very good track record of turning its winners into success stories. But I tell you what, it's got a hell of a better record than its northern counterpart. Canadian Idol ran for 6 seasons in the 2000s where they, no joke, had themed episodes such as Bare Naked Ladies Night and Gordon Lightfoot Night, which I hope is as funny to you as it is to me. Canadian Idol was probably a bad idea from the get-go. American Idol has, what, 10 times the population to work with, and they can't even find one talented person some seasons. So it's not surprising Canadian Idol never made anyone famous, except for, like, this one guy.
Falling 1,000 feet per second. You still take me by surprise.
Yeesh, that's the best I can do. Hope he stays on his side of the border. Carly Rae entered the show in season 5, which, thankfully for her sake, did not have anything so hilarious as Loverboy Night or anything. Let's see how she did.
She keeps the lane chained on in a pretty cabinet. Let them meet.
What couple problems with you? You had some pitchy spots here and there, you know what I mean? You lost the melody a little. It was definitely a little bit on the pitchy side.
Yeah, I've gone through a bunch of her performances on the show, and I didn't see much to suggest she was the next big thing. She came in 3rd and put out an album that didn't really catch anywhere, and for most cases, that's where it would end. But instead of being yet another reality show washout, her career got a huge boost when fellow Canadian teen popper Justin Bieber declared her new song, Call Me Maybe, his favorite song on Twitter. And from there, it spread until everyone was a fan. Except, of course, for me at my lonely little table of one, because be damned if I'm gonna let Justin Bieber dictate my taste in music. Okay, first off, she does not strike me as a great singer. Certainly not in the technical American Idol sense. But she's not terrible either, and pop music is more about personality anyway, and she's cute, video's cute, song's cute, it's all just so excruciatingly cute! Even her name is cute. Carly Rae Jepsen can't possibly be her real name. Look, she's even wearing pigtails here. Holy crap, who actually does that? Who? I'm not trying to be harsh. As a wise man once said, there's nothing wrong with trying to fill the world with silly love songs, but this one's a little sillier than most. Basically, it's a song about meeting a guy. Not, you know, doing anything with him, or dating him, or holding hands with him, or even having a conversation with him. She just gives him her number so that he can call her. Maybe. Wow, that is crazy. Oh my god, you guys, I met this cute boy, and oh my god, I never do this. I gave him my phone number. Oh my god, I know. This is so crazy, you guys, I'm so bad. I'm going to hell. Look, this song is just not for me. I can access my teenage side, I can access my feminine side, but I'm sorry, I can't do both at the same time. I can't find an entry into this because I can't find a way to relate to a teenage girl. Call me unsympathetic, maybe. Oh my god, you guys, his jeans were ripped, and I saw his knees! Now keep in mind, I'm well aware of the power of a good crush song. The thrill of anticipation is a very powerful emotion. In fact, it's probably the only thing about romance this song's target audience knows anything about. But Call Me Maybe just plays it so coy and pussyfoots around everything. I'll never tell, tee hee hee. So let me tell you all about it. You weren't look, but you wished for it. Hot night wind was blowing before you came into my life. I wasn't looking for this. These are phrases used to describe a passionate whirlwind romance, not a scenario where basically nothing has happened yet. The video, which has Carly Rae reading a romance novel and failing to attract the attention of the guy, does a way better job of criticizing this song than I can, honestly. Because it is a fantasy. It's a fantasy about having a fantasy, of meeting some guy worth fantasizing about. Some life-changingly hot guy who makes your knees weak with just his panty-melting stare. It's not a song for anyone who has any experience dating. It's not about actually doing anything except looking, really. He's so mind-bendingly, radiantly gorgeous, you can't even look directly at him. Like the sun. I think Bella Swan describes Edward in exactly the same terms.
You're beautiful.
And, as an added bonus fantasy, you're not only pretty enough that this guy seems interested, he's also the only guy of your many, many suitors worthy of your affections.
You wanna go to the party with me?
I never much liked Taylor Swift's similar adolescent love stories, but at least she had the good sense to cast herself as the underdog. Then again, Carly Rae is smart enough to know that her songs are romance novels and not classic literature. Call that comparison a wash, I guess. I don't like this song, but I really don't like what it represents. When I reviewed Gautier and Fun last month, I optimistically suggested that they represented the beginning of a new trend in pop music, but maybe that was completely wrong. Maybe it wasn't the beginning of a new era, maybe it was the end of it. Maybe there was a brief window of time after club music began to recede at the end of 2010 where interesting, non-stupid music could seep through, and now that window is closing as the next big trend moves in. And that trend is teeny boppery crap. I'm still hoping that we see more stuff like Adele and Gautier in the top 10, but there's also a real chance that pop music will look like the cover of Tiger Beat for the next few years. You know what, before now, I didn't realize how adult pop music has been in the years I reviewed it. Of course, I'm using adult in an extremely relative sense, but say what you want about club music, it does assume that you're old enough to get into the club. But now look where we are. Boy bands are back, Justin Bieber finally has a real hit, and now our new teen princess here. Really, Call Me Maybe is pretty much the most screamingly innocent love song I've ever heard, which I suppose is all you can expect from a pigtailed high school freshman naive like Lil Miss Sweet 16 Carly Rae here. You know what? I should have known. If she was really a teenager, she'd have named this song Text Me Maybe. She's really 26. You're kidding. I suppose it's an accomplishment for an adult to successfully sound like an 8th grader trying to sound like a grown-up. God, if this is what she sounds like now, what did the music from her first album sound like? There's a home I didn't want to beat on this too hard, and Call Me Maybe the song isn't that bad. But Call Me Maybe the phenomenon definitely is. Here's Call Me Maybe sung by a dog. Here's an article from a political journal where they used Call Me Maybe to explain the Euro crisis. I don't get it. Why the widespread acceptance? Why is it spread everywhere so quickly? At what point did the internet start embracing such embarrassingly girly things as this?
Yay.
It all makes sense now. Oh, hey, whoa, crap, I forgot to mention, yeah, speaking of Canada, I'm going to be in Canada next month for Con Bravo, and that's going to be from July 27th to July 29th at the Burlington Hotel and Coat Factory in Burlington, Ontario. So, should be fun, I imagine. So, yeah, that's where I'll be, stalkers. Cool?